Hey there.
Hey, this is a test. Can you hear us? Just make sure you're hearing us okay. Are you hearing us okay? Just please comment in the chat.
Yeah, it's just a test, but please comment so we know you can hear us. Corta el inicio.
Mirando desde la cámara.
Yeah. Hey, who are you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, welcome! We're here to get started with the first virtual meetup of Angular Medellin, right?
Yep. So, just to present ourselves, I am Carlos Lopez, aka Luchillo 17.
Okay.
You have the same t-shirt.
Just fix it. Alright, so, and I am. Oh, shit. Yeah, that's much better.
Okay,
we're new in this. We don't know how to do this properly, but we're gonna do it right from now on. So I'm Juan. I am organizer of Angular Medellin. I work at Juxi as well, just as Carlos. And today we're gonna build an Angular application from scratch. Yes, that's right, from scratch, right?
Yep. He forgot to say, AKA J Herrera.
I'm not. Right? I'm JD Juan. JD Juan. That's my handle. Yeah, that's
right.
Okay, so for this endeavor, we're going to use something called the time box approach, which is a timer that will allow us to set the pair programming time. So whenever I finish coding, this thing is going to ring like this. And that means that Carlos is going to start coding and I'm going to start, like, you know, commenting and just helping him out as long as I can.
Yeah.
If you have any question, you can put it in the comments. Carlos is going to be attentive. And yeah, that's about it. So let's get started, right?
Yeah, time to do this.
Okay, so first thing is, like, we're gonna explain, like, what are we gonna build? What's the challenge we're gonna do here? And that's called Fan Retro. Fan Retro is an application you can use to create retrospectives for your team. So let me show you. If you come, for example, to fanretro.github.io, you're gonna find this application where you will be able to see how to use it. So it's very simple. If you create a new board, you will see that you can add any board name. Perfect. All right, so we create it, and is it running okay there?
Yeah, it's running
okay.
Very well.
And what you're gonna see is this. It's a went well to improve an action items that you can put for your team. So say, for example, after your first sprint with your team, you just kind of have something that you say, like, oh, that went well. So you go ahead and click here, and you write it down. What went well? Certainly the streaming went well. Yeah, right. What went wrong, or action items, you know, like
things to do next time,
get some water for the streaming guys, right? and that's kind of, that's the thing. The important thing of Farm Retro is that it works in real time. So if, for example, I open a new window here, and then I come here and copy the URL, you will see that this information is going to be updated in real time. So if, for example, Carlos just joins and click here and say, hey, we should improve something. What should we improve?
Maybe the
mumbling.
The mumbling. Yeah, the mumbling.
So as Carlos is mumbling, he will see that the other person will see this blurry text. And as soon as he clicks done, it will be there updated. So this is super cool. I've used it for teams. You use it as well, right?
Yeah, we use it all the time in the company, in our retrospective meetings, right? So it's a very useful application for retrospective in general.
Yeah, that's correct. So this is what we're gonna build in Angular from scratch. This is way cooler because you can actually vote and say, like, hey, I like this idea, I'm gonna vote it. And then automatically everyone is updated about the bolts. So by the end of the retrospective, you can select which action items are gonna be, like, prioritized or whatever. So let's get started. First, what I think we should do first is to actually define the scope of what we're going to build. We have about 1 hour, 1 hour and a half So we don't want to get like extend a lot, right?
Yeah, yeah. Front retro is very extensive, so we are going to focus only in the message part and maybe the real time.
That's correct.
Right. Not so much in the part of showing while the people is typing, but the as soon as you add one message, it should appear for the other users.
That's
so
correct.
That's the focus for this virtual meetup.
Yep. And so what I want to explain here is which technologies we are going to use to build this. As you may know, for example, when you're working with real-time databases or information, Firebase is a very good option. There are many more out there. Do you know any other?
Nope.
Okay. But Firebase is a good option because there is something called Angular Fire. Let me share for you. Angular Fire. Here, Angular Fire, which is a super cool kind of like an integration you can use to make like your applications connect. So you can have an Angular front end and a Firebase data layer, which you can just switch. And hoping I'm not showing the screen, right? I'm showing the screen now. There you go. There you have it. This is what we're gonna use: Firebase, Angular Fire, Angular. Anything else?
I think that's everything. Maybe Bootstrap for styles.
Maybe not. Anyway, so I think let's get started. Maybe the first thing we should do is to build the model. Like,
yeah.
What information are we going to store and the whole thing, right?
Yeah, in the development process, it's very important to define the way you are going to deal with data, right? So that's the first thing we are going to do, define models, so we have something set up before trying to deal with interface and everything.
Yeah, that's right. So as you see my screen, I'm going to open a new document, which I was doing here, but you haven't seen anything. I'm going to start over here, and then we're going to start with our model. So if we take a look at Farm Retro, you will realize that we have something like, you know, we have a board, right? We also have a columns, this one over here. We also have our messages, and each message has a voting, right? Like the number of votes it has. And that's kind of more like the general model, but we're not gonna build all of them today. We are gonna build the most important critical factors. We are not sure. Yeah, we are sure.
There is people asking why not Bootstrap?
Why not Bootstrap? Okay, let's get straight about this. Bootstrap is awesome. I mean, it's super cool. It's probably something we don't need in for this test right now, but
yeah.
It's super cool. I mean, I'm not against Bootstrap at all. I mean, super cool tool, in all fine, no racist.
Okay.
No, that's fine. I'm okay with Bootstrap, that's all
right. Yeah, I will not use it for a real application, right? Like not for my kind of application. I will use it maybe if I need to do something very quick.
Good call. Yeah.
Most of the defaults of Bootstrap is not the ones that we use in production applications. Most of the time we will have to edit too much of the Bootstrap code base in order to make it useful for us. So that's why.
That's right. All right, let's get started. So let's get started with our model. So we're going to start with something we call messages, because we believe this is the root of our model. In this case, since we're going to use a Firebase, we're going to use a non-SQL database, which means like the data is stored in a different way than you were used to if you're related with relational databases. In this case, we're going to use a flat structure. So we're going to start with messages, and we're going to say like every message, there you go. So every message is going to have a variable or attributes, right?
Yeah.
Which attribute do you think we should add?
So far, if we are going to use multiple columns, we should have a column ID or sort of a property, right?
Yeah.
And the actual message text.
So we're going to use column, let's leave it like column
yeah.
for now, all right? And the actual text.
The actual text.
So for example, if we have mumbling here, this will be in column 1, and the text will be mumbling.
Yeah, we're going to use index 0 indexed column numbers, okay?
Ah, yeah, 0 index, that's a good one. And you might be wondering about the ID, where's the ID going? It turns out that when you use Firebase, and you push information to Firebase data layer, you automatically get the ID. We're not Firebase experts.
Yeah,
so, right?
And that depends on the way you push it, right?
That's true.
You have to push it through the least data type of Firebase in order to Firebase generate its own unique ID for each message.
That's right. All right. If you haven't heard Firebase before, I'm gonna log in right now. Go to Firebase. I'm gonna actually use incognito. Firebase. Yeah, that's right. So, how about it? Does anyone have any questions so far? Helge in English.
Hell yeah.
Thank you, English. Helge.
Is this live? Yes, this is live.
There's many network interruptions. I suggest not to use UNE anymore. Kidding. So this is Firebase. This is the front page of like website you have. I suggest you to give it a try if you haven't done so yet. There's a new product, by the way, called Firestore. It's pretty neat. It's pretty nice. I suggest you to take a look. It's in beta, still in beta, but it's worth checking it out. So when you log into Firebase, you will see something like this. This is my console, and here I have my personal, private, confidential projects for the FBI, which I'm not gonna show.
Confidential.
Yeah, but anyway, I'm gonna go to the console, and here we can create our own data layers, like our database, correct?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna click here where it says Add Project.
Yeah.
And it's gonna ask for name. What a cool name can we give for this?
Well, hopefully not the same name as Front Retro. I don't want to be sued.
How about Cool Retro?
Cool Retro sounds fun.
Yeah,
sounds
we can get sued by that. So this is gonna be in Colombia. How many people watched us from Colombia?
Oh yeah.
Write in the comments. Okay.
Very much, almost everyone.
Not necessarily everyone. I know someone from Mexico is probably watching this. Josue,
yeah.
Hey, how you doing, man?
Nice. That's why I say almost.
Okay. So right now what you're seeing is that Cool Retro database is being created. So, and it seems like it's done. So let's take a look at what
is
inside.
Yeah.
Right. So we get a get start here. And what you will see is the first thing we need to do is to connect our database to our project, to our front-based project for which we have already created a new Angular application with the CLI. If you want to take a look, what we just did is very simple, very straightforward. We just go ahead there and created something with ng-new virtual meetup. That was like 10 minutes ago. And we created it and it's already running. It's not. I'm going to run it. You can run any Angular project with ng-serve and you can add --open for you to open it in the browser, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's gonna serve from time to time. But let's take a look. I mean, the project is already here. I'm gonna show you. Okay, it's not this one. That's not this one either. It's probably this one. You can also write code dot and then it will open the folder in which your project is like living so you can see it. Oh man.
It's to be.
There it is.
Okay, so here's the project. It's brand new.
Yep.
We haven't done anything. You can't believe us.
Yep.
So we are going to start with this project. It's serve. So if you don't mind, you can show the serve application.
Let's take a look at the serve application. There you go. So welcome to app. This is the first project you get when you create a project with the CLI, right?
Yep.
Okay, so our project is ready. We have already created our database, so I guess it's time to create to connect our database with our application. Is that right?
Yeah. Since we're going to start now with code, start the timer.
That's fine. So we're gonna do pair programming sessions of a couple of 20 minutes.
Yeah.
That's more right.
Okay.
So I'm gonna put 20 minutes and let the games begin. So I'm gonna start. So the first thing we need to do when we're trying to connect Firebase to your front-end application is to actually pass a configuration settings variables into your front-end application or
yeah.
Backend as well. So I'm gonna click here, here's where you can see all the configuration neat, and there you go, there you see it. API key, auth domain, etc., etc. All this information needs to live in your application in order to be able to connect in real time, which is what we're looking for, right?
Yep.
So,
okay, let's start. So we need to grab that configuration, and the optimal place to put that configuration will be in Angular's environment
file. That's right. So let's do that.
So we only need the object.
So I'm going to copy the object, because this is just imports of Firebase, and
yep.
I go to project, and I go to environments folder where the environment configuration
yep.
lives. And in here, I'm going to paste that information, so I'm going to put it here.
Yeah.
So ideally, you might be able to put this inside here. So what we're going to do is that we're going to remove this, and then grab all of this, and put it here in a variable that we're going to call Firebase, how about Firebase configuration.
Okay.
Yeah, one needs.
That semicolon should not go there.
Yep, that's right, good one. All right, perfect. You just added our configuration information in our
Firebase environment.
But
okay.
Yet it turns out that in order to connect your front end application or Angular application to Firebase, you need something called Angular Fire. I mean, you don't need to use it, but you could use it, and it's going to make things a lot easier.
Yep.
David East, if you're watching this, thank you. Anyway, so
there's people asking funny things like what speed does Juxi have?
What speed does Juxi have? Don't blame us. any other question?
I don't see anything. It's unwatchable. Maybe it's actually very
slow.
Very bad. It could be.
Interesting.
Because I think I've seen it loading multiple times, to be honest.
Let me see. Everything looks okay.
Except there's a lot of drops.
But 51% is still okay.
It's somewhat. It's half of the actual video.
Anyway, this is gonna keep recording. It's probably gonna get better along with time. You're gonna have the video by the end of the recording streaming, is right?
Yeah, this will be recorded, and the hope is to upload it to YouTube later, so everyone can look it any other time. Okay.
All right. So let's get going. What we're gonna do now is use Angular Fire to connect. So what we're gonna do is go to Angular Fire, right?
Yeah, we should go to Angular Fire and let's look at the documentation to see what we have to do to make it run.
Okay, so according to Angular Fire, let's see. So it's a observable base, which is pretty neat. It's real-time bind. There's real-time bindings, authentication, etc., etc. We need to install some dependencies, so that's what we're gonna do now. We're gonna go ahead and copy these lines, but yet we're not gonna use
npm.
Yeah, we're gonna use yarn because we like yarn. We're gonna keep yarn and then we right click, and then we're not gonna use save because the yarn doesn't save. Is that right?
Save.
Okay, perfect. So I'm gonna do this. Okay, so it's going well. Next thing, it turns out we need to let's see. So this is Firestore implementation.
Firestore is the other one,
which we are not using right now. Maybe later. We need some installation and setup guide. So coming here, we need some prerequisites, CLI that's working perfectly. Blah, blah,
project
blah.
Test, etc.
Yeah, we already done this. So we need our configuration variables, which we already set up.
Yeah.
Maybe we should change this to Firebase to keep it standard.
Maybe.
And then we have the Angular Fire module, where we actually need the Angular
database module.
Angular Fire database module. So this is the first thing we're going to do. When you're working with modules, you need to make sure you import them into the module that requires it. In this case, is the app module. So I'm going to copy this and I'm going to go to the app module.
Yeah.
And come over here, and then copy this.
Yeah, and we have to change it for Firebase database.
Angular, yeah, maybe this is already finished. No, this haven't finished, but that's alright.
Angular Fire 2 has the typings embedded in the actual library.
Yeah. So technically, I should be able to delete this Angular Fire database. It's not working.
I think you have to use Angular Fire 2
/database. Let's try. It worked.
Yep.
It should be database module. Yeah, there you go.
There it is.
Perfect. So now we put this into the imports. So we put it over here, and that should be it.
Yep. As far as the, no, you have to use a for something for instance. I don't remember. Let's look to the documentation.
All right. We're gonna hold on 5 minutes. We'll be back in 5 minutes. We're gonna try to fix the stream a little bit and see if we can do something about it. Be right back. Our stream.
Okay, guys.
Okay, we're back.
Sorry about that. We have tried some things in order to make the stream better, and hopefully it should be better. If not, let us know so we can fix it.
We cannot fix it actually, but let's keep going. All right. So we were okay. So we already installed Angular Fire. We have it here, and we put it in our project, which is over here, and we already initialized our module. Wait, we haven't. So the next step is to actually, in Angular Fire, we need to initialize our module according to the documentation. And to do this, we need a method called initialize app. Is that correct?
Yep.
Actually, we may need the Angular Fire module. I don't think this is Angular Fire Starter. Do you know?
That sounds about right?
Yeah, I guess we are, actually, it's often we use both. Angular Fire database module. So
it's very likely like that.
So we're gonna import this one, and then we're gonna get environments from the
environments.
Yep. And we're gonna change environments because it's now pointing to the right one. So it's just gonna be Firebase. Yep.
So it doesn't matter the actual name of the variable because we are putting inside the execution of initialize app.
Yep. Oh shit, I should be putting the second screen. Yeah, there you go.
Okay, KC is extra typings.
See,
yeah.
Typos.
Typos.
Okay. And I'm going to save all of them. And we're good.
We are good. Okay. So let's see what else does the documentation say about how to implement Angular Fire in an application. So
it looks like there's nothing special. I mean,
this is just custom stuff.
Yeah, we're using database module. This is the one we're using.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, you were right. They were two.
Okay. So next thing we need to do is to actually. I'm gonna give it another 10 minutes.
Okay.
And okay. So next thing we need to do is to go
to the component, the app component, in order to import the Angular Fire database service.
Yep. That's
and
correct.
And start working with it.
So let's go to the service. I'm gonna go
app
to
component.
App component. .ts. I'm gonna use a constructor to import the service.
Yeah.
So we need to look up for the service because I don't remember the name, but it's pretty simple, I'm pretty sure. If we looked it up in the documentation under the
it's actually a Fire database. So
we look up here, and then we have this documentation right here that says. Now, in order to use it, we may need to use Angular Fire Database Service.
Yep.
So this is what I'm going to import. I'm going to get this over here. Actually, I'm going to get all this code.
Yep.
And just going to put it here.
Remember to put maybe public or private in DB so we can access it
outside
of the constructor.
That should be the typo for them.
Yep.
Right? Okay. And I'm going to query some information, but actually we don't have any information now, so that's all right. That's not a problem.
Yeah, that's not a problem.
So let's see if the application is still working.
You have to declare the items variable that is being... Okay.
No.
You can also comment it.
Because we don't, because we don't have any info. Just going to remove all of this and go to see if the application is still working. Okay, perfect. It's supposed to be white. No problems. I'm going to dock this. To the right. Yeah, there we go. So
okay.
It's white, it's all working. What should we do now? We should push some information,
shouldn't we? Yeah, we need data in order to show, so we are going to push an information. So I think the what we should do is maybe create a little form and a button to send the data.
How about if we first send the information to the server,
and
like,
see how
like
it works.
By default, with the full information, and then we can import the form, okay?
Yeah,
so let's... How about if we call database... How should we do this? I don't remember.
db.list.push. We are going to push as list. So, db.list...
Dot list...
Dot... should be...
But the list needs... Okay, so list needs a name of
The path of the object we are going to push.
Which
so
we're
going to
use messages, right?
Yep.
Which we define over here. Which we have messages,
call and text. Yeah.
So we're
and
gonna.
You have to stop.
So we're gonna
zooming.
Do. Sorry, I like it.
yeah, push. We are going to pass a few things. I think the object with the two variables, which should be the column. Let's start with index 0.
Okay, so the column will be 0, for example.
Yep.
And the text will be something to improve. Wait, maybe we can improve the streaming. Now we can improve the streaming, I get that. Okay,
yep.
Perfect. But before that, before we hit anything or save anything, let's go here and go to our database. This is where you can see your database, which currently, we're going to get started, right?
Okay.
Which currently has nothing in it.
Currently, yeah.
Currently. In order to be able to authenticate into your database and to read and write content, you need to go to the rules section where you can. You are supposed to set this to equal null, for example. I just read this. I'm not a Firebase expert, but I know this works.
Yeah.
That's important because otherwise you need to be authenticated in order to modify your data
the
set.
Yeah. Also to read, if you are not authenticated, you cannot read. So.
Yes,
it's important to change both.
And there we are, we have nothing, and now we're gonna put this aside, we're gonna go back here, and we're gonna see what happens in the information when we get here and click save. See if the information is pushed. One,
two,
three. Ignition.
And
okay. Ignition, there
nice.
You go.
Okay, and there is the ID we promised you that Firebase will create for us.
Yeah, that's
right?
Correct. Is there another comment there?
Not only that we were not showing the code before, but it's already fixed. So, Curtis, please, if you can, let us know if it's better than before the stream.
So we have 82% of draw frames.
Oh, it's even worse.
Is that database? That bad?
Yeah.
You know what? Maybe I think we should continue anyway.
We should?
Shall we? Or should we?
Maybe we should post it like in YouTube later because.
Yeah, that's fine.
We already started, right?
Okay. So, the information is pushed. So that's a good start.
Yeah. So we have the information, the first message. Should we push maybe a few, two or three, like to have something to show when we start
yep.
making the.
So I'm gonna change something and
wait,
then save again.
Yeah, try to change the text.
Streaming. So maybe something else we should improve. How about
configuring Twitch better?
Twitch configuration. Twitch configuration. Let's save again. This goes for whatever, another column.
Okay, and there it is. Column should have one.
Yep,
yes.
There we go. And let's add another one. Something else we should improve. Something that went well.
Okay, we are explaining the topic of the structure of the application.
The video recording went well then.
Hopefully.
And explanation. Explanation. And this goes for columns number two, for example. And there we have it. 3, 2, 1. There you go. So there it is. It's
yep.
working.
Nice.
So, well, what else? What else shall we...
Okay. Now that we have this, we should remove that so we are not pushing more things into the database.
So maybe we should put that into a method.
Yeah.
Shall we? Well, all right. Let's get this. Let's go to a method. Let's call it... Shall we call it
add message?
Add message, that's right. And
okay.
It should.
So now it will be just a button.
It should get the column like a number and then just put it here.
For now. Okay.
Just like.
Okay,
number,
yes.
Column. Oh, then maybe we can do this.
Oh,
do
yeah.
You know that one?
Yeah, that's because of the destructuring the TypeScript give us.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, so we're good. So show the information, right?
Yeah, now we are going to show the information. So the first thing to do is have a variable where to store the information. So messages, that
Let's
will be unobservable.
We can leave it like that for now. We
well,
can.
We could. We can.
And then say this.messages equals to.
This is the B.
this DB, then
object, because we need the IDs.
So this is a method in the API that allows us to access the whole information along with the IDs you see before. This one's over here. So we're gonna call object, and then we're gonna go to
messages path.
Yep. And then we need a method called value changes, right?
Yeah.
That any time the value changes of the messages, object, then it's going to be updated. As an observable, gets updated. So
yeah.
I'm going to go over here and
this returns an observable. So maybe we should
use async pipe.
Yeah, that's why I told you to use an observable. So it should have like the standard dollar sign.
Oh, that's
notation.
Right. Yeah, this is a good one. Yeah, I'm gonna change that one right now. With here, dollar sign.
Yep.
Okay, and let's go back here and then just good one.
Yeah.
Here. So I should put
message pipe async.
The async pipe will allow us to subscribe in the template.
And JSON in order to show in a very much more readable way the data that comes from the server.
Now let's go and see what's there. Nothing.
No. Why no?
Do we have nothing there? Let's see
what. Really?
Async JSON messages, because we forget
the dollar sign. Yeah.
Yeah. There we go. Let's see if I finished.
Yeah.
There you go. Okay,
nice.
It's their turn.
Okay, my turn.
So
it was 20 minutes, if I recall correctly.
Yep.
Now let's see what's next. So we have the JSON object. Now what we should do is split the respective messages into their columns.
Yeah.
Right. So I think what we will do is maybe get the messages and do a map over them and split them in different arrays.
Correct.
One for each column. Right.
That's fine. So how about if we create three variables for it?
Yeah, it sounds very good. So how do we call it?
Let's call it
went well.
Yep.
To improve.
Yep.
And
action items.
Action items. Okay. Do you want to make them observable? Because we can just make filters and maps over the observable of messages.
So what you're suggesting is to
use the RSGS types and observable operators in order to map the data to what we want that are split.
Yeah, I like that approach. Let's do that. So use the dollar sign for it.
Yeah. So let's see, that doesn't work here. Okay. Dollar sign here, here, and here.
Perfect.
Now, what we should do is we have these messages. Now we need to assign this dot when went well.
Yep.
So let's map these messages with a pipe, which is the new. Wait, what? These messages should be an observable, which is not because we have not yet used any typings at all.
So it will be observable, but yet we don't have the typings yet, right? So maybe we should
RSGS observable import,
yep.
And tell it.
Just let it like any for now.
Yeah.
And then let's go create a model.
Okay. Yeah, we should create the state model right now.
Yep. So let's go
okay.
Create like oh, yeah.
Okay, so let's see. Where do we put it?
Just right
inside
there.
The
yeah.
Okay. So
let's call it message. Message.model.ts.
Okay, so it will be an interface.
Yep. So it's for interface.
message. It should have a what do you call it?
Colon. And then we it should have text, the time number, and it should have text.
Okay, should we put the ID because we are going to map it later to have the ID available?
Yep.
So I think it should be ID like this, like optional, because we before we map it, we don't have the ID. After we make we map it, we should have the IDs.
Oh, so no, we don't have to worry about that because we don't. We're actually now. Oh, I see. But oh, yeah.
Yeah, and it should be string as well. So right?
See.
Okay, so that's the message. Then we should replace these anys with message, and we have to import it.
Yep.
Message model. Okay. Now we should have here the messages, and is screaming because he doesn't know which kind of observable value changes.
So we can do it. I guess we can use the
like this, right? But I don't remember.
I think it's an object, or just try both.
Okay. Let's see.
Message.
Okay, that was it.
That worked.
Okay, so
let's
when
you use the
here.
Pipe operator, right?
Yeah. So let's. I want to give me a second. Okay. So let's map this one first in order to transform it into an array that we can filter. So pipe. Map. This should be imported from RxJS operators.
Yep, that one. Second
yeah,
one.
Yeah. It's just that if we
you can
one,
change it to it's in plural, isn't it?
Operators.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. So we have map. Then inside map we reset a function. So we have a message.
Do you want to move here? Like do you controls K, control Z, control K, and then Z.
Control K C.
No, just control K and then Z. There you go. And then you can
send mode. Okay.
Yeah, send mode. And then you can zoom in a little bit and maybe rest under here so people can see it right. Yep.
Okay. So we are getting here the messages and we need to map those in order to turn it into an array.
Yeah.
So I have a few suggestions about it. What do you think of using a Lodash map, which also iterates over arrays?
So this
over objects. Sorry.
So no, let's not add another dependency. Let's do it like JavaScript.
Okay.
It's very simple. For off will iterate over the keys.
If we use object.entries, right?
If we use object.entries, it will give us the keys.
Yeah, that's the idea. So we use the new ES6 object.entries for getting both the key and the actual object. So we pass message, and then in iterator we should have the actual message. Sorry, this should be a... what do you use? How do you use? There it is. So key dot message. So according to typings, this should be any. This should be string. Any why any?
Let's see. I want to try.
Because messages is of type message. Okay, this should be a message object. How do we parse this so it knows it's a message object? Because, it's an object with message keys, so we need another interface.
No, but the interface is hard to, it's a little complex to create because it will have like...
it's very easy. Certainly.
Because we need a dynamic ID.
Yeah, let me...
I've done it before. It doesn't work quite well. We can try.
Export interface. How should we call it? A message container or something?
Yeah, you can call it Firebase message. Iterate or keys JS.
Firebase message, and this should be of type key string message. So what this interface allows to do is tell it, okay, Firebase will handle us an object which every key is a string which represents the IDs.
Okay.
And the actual object inside those IDs is the message object, right?
Okay.
That's
yeah.
why I wanted this one, this ID to be optional, because after before we map it, it doesn't exist. After we map it, it will exist. That's the idea.
Okay.
So we have four key messages. This should be changed to Firebase message. And imported from module.
Okay.
And so message should be a Firebase message, and message itself should be a single message, and the key is still string. So everything is good in the world. Okay, so we have to we need an array, right? So
and we want to iterate over it in order to what? Oh, to separate them, right?
Yeah. To push them in there.
Yeah, but we don't need to. Okay.
We have to. If not, it will be easier if we use Lodash. But if we want to use the native things of ES.
So you're gonna put them in an array.
Yeah.
And then you're gonna and how you're gonna map it to the different observables.
That will be done later in the other observables. We are going to pipe each one with a different filter function, right? So that we can separate each one.
How about if we do the filter right now here?
Then we will need to.
But are you talking about filter function of observable filter or map or array filter?
Array filter. It will be an observable map, and inside the map an array filter.
So we can do the filter right now. Actually, because we
yeah,
had a message.
But then how do we split it in between the actual variables? That should...
Oh, okay, so what you're doing is that you return an array
yeah, and
in
then,
the form of message.
Yeah, in messages will be an array of messages, and then in WentWell and the other observables, we are going to pipe it to map, and then filter with array filter.
Okay, that's fine. Sounds
that's
cool.
The idea.
So
okay.
You're going to push to the R...
Yeah, that's the idea.
Dot push message.
Yeah, not exactly. So we need the ID. So we need this ID equals key, and the address will be
message.
Message.
Yep, that's correct.
Yeah, message. So we are going. We are using the actual. How do you call it?
A spread operator.
A spread operator to push a new object that contains the key and the actual other properties of the message object.
Okay.
And then we have to return the array after the four. Okay. So the other thing. This should be actually an. Message array.
Ah, that's right, yeah.
Okay.
You should do the same for everyone else.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was a good implementation. Okay. So
okay.
That's working, and now we need to do a filter.
This is the message dot pipe, right? Another map. And this map what we'll do is it will get a messages array, and we are going to filter it as messages.filter. This receives another function. Sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. Messages, it gets the type strings right away.
Yeah.
Right.
So message, and this will be message
dot
ID.
The
color. Sorry, column.
Equals to.
Zero in this case.
That's correct. So you just copy paste the lines and do it for the three columns.
Yeah, that's the idea. So we have this. we duplicate this and this, and we change names.
That's correct.
Want to say something meanwhile I change this?
Let's see. I was reading through the comments. Seems like it's going well. Yep.
And action idea.
Okay. So good. It's a little pixelated, but that's fine. I mean, it's getting better than before.
Nice. One.
And it's real time, which is good. I think it's because people is leaving the office, so it's getting better.
Yeah, we should consider doing this in
the night, or maybe Saturday morning,
so there is not so many people in here that the connection gets cluttered.
That's right.
Okay.
All right.
So we have the observables. We should print them in the HTML to see if the filter is working.
Okay. So let's go to the template and then duplicate those lines.
Okay, we should put like a
Wendwell and the whole thing.
Okay, the message is not needed anymore because we know we are parsing them. So it should be
Auto-complete. I don't have that extension. It's called Angular Services. I don't have it.
Yeah, Angular Services. Yeah, that's a shame.
Why?
Well, because it's very useful. Okay, because it saves us from typing variables.
I don't know. It doesn't work so well for me.
Okay, went well to improve.
It's almost real time, this thing. See, it wasn't anything. It was the bandwidth that the other people were using at the office.
Yeah.
Okay,
to improve, and the last one was action items.
That's correct. All right, let's see if that's working. You want to save all the files right away with Ctrl K, Ctrl S.
Give me a second. I like this way.
Okay. Let's see.
Okay, it should be this one. So we should see.
Nice.
Arrays. Nice.
Congratulations. Well, craftily done.
Yeah. Nice. Okay. So we have three different splitted objects. Observables for the different columns.
Yeah.
Right? So what about we start adding styles on itself, like a template?
Let's see what we have in our agenda. So, separate the columns, input with a push.
Oh, okay, that's a good idea.
So let's do an input.
We should make an input for pushing into the database.
Yeah. So you want to create just an input in the template, like on the top, or maybe down there, whatever. On the top, I think on the top it's better, because otherwise, when you have more information, it's going to be...
Okay, so input.
Input, it will auto-complete.
Input. I'm searching for text.
Yep.
And
we're gonna
doesn't care, ID neither.
And now we're gonna do like
ng model maybe.
No, ng model exactly. So no, then
not this one. That's one for Angular JS, not Angular 2+.
And
so
and you map it to the variable, which is gonna be, for example, let's call it message input. Input message. And then you have to wrap ngModel in between parentheses and then square.
Oh, yeah, that's called a banana in a box.
Yeah, but how do you call the square parentheses?
Brackets.
Yeah.
This is brackets. The other ones are curly braces, right?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Anyway, so you have to go and create a variable and also import the forms module your app module, which is all right. You can just go to the app module and just import forms module in your imports.
Forms module.
Yep, and you... No. I don't think we'll do it by itself, so you can just duplicate ng module and then instead of core, you put down there the first one.
Yeah, okay.
And you put forms, which is in plural. Yeah, and then you put forms module there.
There is
forms
module.
Nice. Now we need to create a variable in the component. You can go back. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And then
there
create
is.
Up there.
So we need to create a variable here for the message, which is called input message.
Yep. Which is of type string.
string?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, only the string. I was thinking finding the object with the from start, maybe.
From start? Oh, message.
Yeah, message.
Is that a good idea? No, because on general will give you a text and a string and you kind of map that.
No, but you can use a message dot.
Oh, I see. You're right. Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Message dot text.
That's right. That's right. You're right.
Okay, message. It should have a by default
it's
an empty object. I'm guessing.
You had a typo there.
Message. Should we initialize it to an empty string? Empty object.
Should we?
Maybe it's
yeah. Otherwise, you're gonna get undefined. I cannot get property text of undefined.
So you
have to initialize an object just like that. And you don't need to pass an ID, which is good, but you need to pass a column. So by default, you're going to put a column, which is column 0.
Okay, column 0 for
now.
And the text
will be empty for
will
now.
Will be empty string.
Yeah, that's right. And if you and let's go to the component and show input message below with a string interpolation to see what it's inside.
Okay, so this should be actually input message.txt.
That's right.
And
with the string interpolation, you're going to show the comments.
We should show it here, right? Okay. I hate when that happens. So input
message.
And there is the queue for Juan to start building.
Yep. Your turn.
My turn. And
so
you weren't seeing the comments, right?
So we forgot to put the JSON pipe here. So I'm going to put it here and then save. And it's going to show an empty object. There you go. Now, as soon as it detects here, it's going to be updated. Let's try. Yeah.
It's working.
It's working.
So what we need to do is now to put a button there that as soon as I click the button, it will push the information to Firebase. To do that, it's very simple. We just put a button here. Not that
maybe,
button.
Maybe remove your
yeah
uppercase.
Button disable. Not disable.
Not disable.
Yeah. And then this button is going to have an event, which I'm going to call with once it's clicked. Which is gonna call? It's gonna be called add message.
Okay, add message.
Which is gonna have an add message stringer, and then I'm gonna go back here. I'm gonna create a method add message.
Which is already existing.
It already exists.
So we
don't need to pass any information. We can actually get the variable that it is pointing to.
Yeah.
Which is
this dot message input message.
This dot input message.
Though input message only has the text, we should the only thing that has by default is the
column, which is already set, so that's fine.
Okay, yeah, and the push will take care of the ID, so it's okay. So
it should. So as soon as I add some text here and it called method add message,
it should update in the
this one
first
instantly.
Array.
Instantly. That's
yeah.
right.
Though I think it's not going to work. Because you have a typo in the HTML.
Or do I?
Yep. It should be a message function. So
you
need the parentheses.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Yeah, that's about it. You're right. Good one.
Okay. So.
Instantly. Instantly.
Instantly.
One.
Okay.
Two. Three.
Three.
There
nice.
You go. So it means that if I go to my Firebase.
Database.
Which will be around here. Yeah, it is here instantly. Perfect.
Yeah.
So that's all good. And we are very close, except for the visual part. So now we need to start wrapping down this project, right?
Yeah.
So we're going to make it simple. We're going to make it according to what we want to do is that it's to actually separate the different columns
yeah.
and to add a form for every column, and then we're done because
yeah.
I will be able to see the information and also to push the information to different columns. So
yeah.
That
so it's time to start using the HTML to make templates stuff like showing the different columns maybe add borders and stuff and the styles.
Yeah.
So let's start simple. Let's add four divs, three inside one div.
Let's see what Carlos is trying to make us do. So you mean one div, right?
Yeah, div.
Yeah.
Okay. Inside that div should be three divs.
Yeah.
And each div should have one for the message, which will have the ng4, and one for the actual form, the input and the button.
So each one of these divs will have a class that is gonna have a class that is gonna be board, right? It's called board.
Column.
And then each one of them will have like an ng function.
One div inside and one.
There you go. So it's gonna be inside it. We're gonna have some other divs.
Yeah.
Which is gonna be.
So for now,
iterated.
I'm counting in two. One that is going to be the message iterated with ng4, and the other which will contain a copy of input and button for sending the actual message. So
okay, so let's start showing the information correctly, if that's okay.
Okay.
So if we want to show the information in here, so technically what we need to do is just put in this thing in here, and that should be it actually, right? So I'm going to copy
for starters.
It. Yeah, like to start.
Yeah, for starters. So let's see how it looks.
So let's do something else. We actually don't need the whole information, like the colon, and we actually only need the text. So what we can do here is that we can wrap this into parentheses
and
then just
text
and then like
interrogation.
Let's try this first and see if that works. So I'm gonna do the same for all of them. I'm gonna put this thing here and then I'm gonna replace this thing. Right? I'm sorry. And then I'm gonna remove this one and then I'm gonna use this one here. Which is replacing action items here, and then I'm missing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we have the columns. We have the. It should be showing in three different divs. The actual test.
Oh, we had an error.
I know why. Because we are trying to get the text of a single message, but that is an array. So we should no. It's an array. Yeah, it's an array.
Oh.
So
we need the ng4. So let's do the ng4, which is pretty simple. So what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna do it in here inside the div.
Yeah.
Put the div here. Right. Open it. I'm gonna put in my ng4 here using my ng4 async snippet, from someone else. And then I'm gonna say like every one of them is called a call message. And the thing will be called
Went well, right? Okay.
So it's gonna be went well.
Dollar sign.
Yeah.
That's
unnecessary.
That.
And then we can do message.test.
Not in there, but inside the actual div.
That's correct. And then we put it in here. And there you go. Let's see if this works. I'm gonna comment this for now.
Yeah, comment that, please.
And
it should show if each message, which should be two, I think.
Nice, that's
same
working.
And instantly. Nice.
So let's go to this our styles here they are. And that's some class for the column for now. And then maybe we can use some others we have around. So I'm gonna use border just to identify them better. And I use
1 pixel or two pixels.
2 pixels, solid, and with a nice gray color, which is gonna be green.
Almost gray.
And see how.
Okay, so that's
there.
The
you go.
Column.
That's our column. We need an art here, which is display, and we're gonna use
display
inline block, which will make
right.
It. We'll take the space it needs. Nice, and we can also do something here super quick, which is a padding. We're gonna keep 3RM. To make some space.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. So I used to match, maybe we can use 1RM here. And maybe just one of our last thing is just merging, which is gonna be 1RM. And that should be about it. Perfect.
Okay.
So
yeah,
we need three of them.
We need three of them.
Which
yeah.
We already have. So we need to replicate the code for all the alerts and we should be fine. So I'm gonna duplicate this and then take this text.
Yeah, to improve inside the second went well. Then.
Oh shit. Sorry.
Still missing the control V.
Yeah, I'm missing a lot. And this one. For this one.
Yeah.
And then I remove this.
Bye bye comments.
And
we should have the three of them.
Perfect.
One of
in
them.
A brilliant way.
Yeah,
we just need to actually. Yeah, there you go.
There you go. Yeah.
So we need to, if technically, if we keep having staff here, it will show up there in the green box.
Yeah, it should.
In the green box. In the green box. Let's see.
Nice.
Perfect. So we are now almost there. We should add some title to every one of them. So then we can add an H1, which is
went
well. Another one, which will be
to improve.
And maybe another one, which is
Action items. Nice.
Let's see how it looks. That's a little too big, so
yeah.
Maybe we can use an H2
H3.
Instead. H3, okay.
I think H3 should be okay. Maybe.
Yeah, much
okay.
Better. Okay. Okay, so.
So let's start maybe adding the forms. Right?
Okay. I just want to fix this. Sorry, I need to fix it.
Yeah, it looks very.
Yeah, much better.
Okay. So we,
need to put every input inside every of these boxes.
Yeah.
All right?
Okay, so very likely we will need three different message models.
Maybe we can just send the column here.
That's
it. Oh, I see your point.
Yeah, because every input will be different from
each
other.
Will be mapped into a different variable.
Yeah, and if you start changing one input, the other will update with the same value.
Okay.
So either we don't use the ng module, but instead we pass the instance variable into the addMessage function, and we query for the
instance variables. Well, you mean me several? You mean this?
No, I mean the if you use the dash a variable in input to get the HTML reference of the
which is pretty much the same thing. Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, you're right. So let's fix this input and then we replicate for all the So we're not gonna use ngModel anymore.
Nope.
Okay, that's fine. But hey, how about this? I got a better idea. How about if we create a method? Which is called keyApp.enter. So it will be enter every time I press keyApp. And then I do called addMessage, but then I send the instance variable. Yet, I don't need the instance variable because I can send this and then access.
Yeah, you can send the event and give the
target.value, which will send the text right away.
Yeah.
So I can get rid of this, right? And I could get rid of this, and then I could go to the component and get rid of this actually as well.
Yep, and just
and then
use the add message which expects
a text
string
of type string, and then that text should be inside here
as an object, so
and it
the
should have
column.
A column, right?
Yeah.
Which it should take as well.
Yeah,
but for
later,
now let's leave it like two.
By default, two. Okay.
And then we put text which will be just like that.
Yep, excellent. So it should be able to push to the action items.
So I'm gonna text, I just hit enter, and I hit enter. There you go, it's working. And
nice.
The streaming is looking much better now.
Yeah.
Yay. So if you have any questions or comments, you can put them right here. If you wanted to elaborate on something, just do it, no problem.
Or if you want us to slow down, because we are...
We're not slowing down. Very okay. So let's get this finished. We're almost there. What we need to do is to replicate this input, super cool input,
in every column. So before you do that, I think just put it there.
So should I put it
below
here,
right?
And then I'm gonna add
an extra parameter into the function, which should be the column 0, 1, and 2.
0, 1, and 2. And I
here
should get
the
column here,
column, yeah.
Which will be a number.
And we can just remove the value of column there.
Exactly.
Nice.
And we're almost there. We'll see how it looks.
Okay, 1, 2,
perfect.
3. So
let's start. Nothing to improve. Perfect.
Nice. Okay.
Good.
It's
we made
good.
It.
Yeah.
I think we made it.
It's real time, basically. Yeah.
And yeah.
The only thing left,
you know,
is
we should do duplicate this and put it down here.
Oh yeah, to see
if it's
work,
it's actually real time, right?
Yeah.
So we have the three columns here, and let's go to improve and say really, okay, really nothing. There you go.
Yeah, we have.
We achieved it.
We shipped it. Yeah.
Super happy. It's actually a great job. I mean, for 1 hour only.
Yeah, for 1 hour is very good.
Yuppie. There you go. I think this kind of covers what we wanted to do. I mean, we could add some remove item and a lot of things more, but I think this is pretty neat.
Yeah, this is the base of the application. From now on, it's just adding features like the removal, the CRUD operations, styles and everything.
Huh.
Maybe login and everything.
Hello
from
Germany.
Germany.
Something in German. Doppelgänger. Kein Problem.
I don't know anything in German.
Anyway, so so this is it. This is working. We're going to share the code with you outside. If you want to take a look at it, it's pretty simple. This can be improved in a lot of ways. We tried to do it just quick for people to actually kind of like understand the big picture, but we're going to do some wrap up of what we do. So let's start. I'm going to save here. I'm going to start from zero of what we do. So we wanted to view this, which we were very close. Look at it.
Yeah.
And we wanted to do some real time with Firebase, which is over here, where we created a model. That model lives over here. It's a very simple model, which is this one. We wanted to view messages that had a colon and
a text
and would
yeah.
give us, like, they should know where to point to, right?
Yep.
And so we installed AngularFire in our application. So if we go to our package.json, you should be able to see something called
Firebase
and also AngularFire
2.
So
yeah.
That's what we recently communicate. So after that, what we did was to go to environment and to add some variable configurations that allow our application to connect with the
Firebase
database.
Yeah.
And what we did after that, we...
Okay, we opened the module,
the app module,
and we imported the modules necessary for AngularFire, which is AngularFire module, which needs the configuration we had in environments.
Yep.
Then use the AngularFire database module in order to use the real-time database.
Yep.
Then
and that was it.
That
right.
was it.
So
as far as configuration goes.
Yeah, and after that we can just go to our component, which in this case is
app component.ts,
and in our constructor we use AngularFire database, which allows us to query information from the database or also push information. So what we did is that we use some of our RxJS skills, which consists of turning our information actually into arrays. Right, arrays of information we can use for later. We use that with a pipe, and then we filter the information for a variable, which is messages, when will to improve and action items.
Yep.
These observables were then later mapped to our template, which you can see here when we do
the async pipe in every ng4.
Yeah, exactly, right here. Every async pipe you see here, I'm gonna highlight this. Yeah, this one. Yeah, so we have the went well to improve and action items with the async pipe, which allows us to show the information. And then finally, we added an input type with a key up enter method, which allows us to add the messages sending these parameters. What are these parameters, Carlos?
Okay, the first one is the event. Event is the reference to the input field, right? So to the HTML DOM element. So we use target.value in order to get the text inside the input and send it to the app message function, along with a number parameter that is the column in which this message is going to be inserted.
Yeah, exactly. Just he couldn't say better. And then we have a different method for every different column, which zero, the same method for different columns, with different parameters, so 0, 1, and 2, which in turn is going to call this method over here that is going to push the information to our Firebase database.
Okay, and remember that by pushing through list, it will create its own ID, so we don't have to worry about that. If we were to use that in a normal database, we will have to worry about that by using maybe a library for unique ID generation.
Yeah.
But right now, Firebase takes care of that for us, so all green. Everything is good in the world.
You nail it, guys.
Yep.
Anyway, I think this should be it. I think we can explore more in the next virtual meetup. But hey, thank you very much for watching. If you have any comment, you can put it right now. You have 5 seconds before we stop the streaming. So it's up to you. Any other thing?
Yeah, maybe wait a bit if they have questions or something.
In other case, we're sorry for the bitrate issues. We didn't expect that to be as bad. It was a little bad. Yet, after some people leave the office, it got much better. So this is something we learned that,
yeah.
That we should do it maybe in the night, maybe from 7 to 9 p.m.
Yeah, when we have all the bandwidth for
us
alone.
Yeah, or maybe we can do it on Saturday morning, Saturday afternoon, which could be okay as well.
Yeah, if possible, you could comment which way do you prefer, maybe Friday night or Saturday in the morning, in the meetup group.
Yeah, in the meetup group, you can let us know, or maybe in the chat right now. Apparently, everyone agrees that both times are perfect.
Okay, we have something. Clear the input when you enter in the input field. That's a
challenge
input.
For Mohammed. Sure, man. Let's do this. So if we want to clear the input, what should we do? Let's go to the composition. So
okay.
We want to clear it. What should we do?
Okay, we have to tell to assign empty string to the actual input. So I think instead of using target.value, we let the event go down into the function, and in the function we have access to the DOM element to clear the input.
So we should send. So what should we send here? Just the event?
Yeah, just the
or
event.
Or just the target? Maybe the
target.
Right?
Target is enough.
So I'm gonna remove this. I'm gonna send the target.
Okay.
So I'm gonna go all the way here.
So text is not text, but the actual input. So,
so that's a DOM element
HTML
that I don't remember.
HTML input element.
HTML. Wow.
That exists.
I didn't know that. So
yeah.
We got the input, and then we're going to get the text.
So
for that, we're going to create the text.
Input dot text value.
Right? And then after that, we're going to do input dot value equals nothing.
Does that work?
Of course.
I thought that we will need to use like a different function that clears the input. Let's try.
You nail it again.
It works.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that was about it. What else he said?
That we can use the structuring to get the actual.
That was a good one. Yeah.
No,
yeah.
Actually, we cannot because it's not named. It doesn't have the same name. It's input
value. Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, he just said that.
Yeah. Const value input, but then we will have to assign the value down into the list. So. Yeah,
input. What do you mean? Yeah, I mean, it's pretty much the same thing, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, like the only way to make this smaller is if we drop the input.value equals empty string below the list and we use input.value inside the push. Like text, semicolon, input.value.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the only way I can see to make it smaller as far as I can think about.
Let's see if that keeps working. Keeps working. Yeah.
Yep. Nice.
Cons but
oh yeah, you can rename when destructuring.
Hi,
I
didn't know that one.
Yeah, I forgot you can do that.
Let's do that.
Just for the sake of fanciness.
Yeah, fanciness. So I didn't know that.
Okay, so you copy text, semicolon, value. Sorry, value semicolon text.
So that's not semicolon, it's just
colon.
Text.
And
that's an input. Is that right?
Yeah.
So that
gets rid of the input value
so,
in the push. Right.
So if I'm getting this, how about if I say text equals nothing? Will that empty the input because it's a string, so it's not passing the reference but the primitive value, right? So Mohammed, what's his name?
Mohammed
is great.
Mohammed Samakhan.
That's fine.
It's hard to pronounce. I'm sorry.
Thank you. Thanks.
Which country are you from, Mohammed?
Sure, no problem, man. Hey, keep watching. Thank you very much for everything here. See you next time. Hope you subscribe for you to know when we're going to publish again. Follow us on Twitter at JD Juan, or you can follow this guy on Twitter.
Luchillo17.
You can take it down if you want to.
Okay.
And you say, hey, man, thank you. All right. Stopping streaming. See you next time.